So, you know when you got like hundreds of old planes that you just need to get rid of? What do you do with them? Well, plane heads, this is your answer. The boneyard. This incredible jet retirement village is where the U.S. Air Force sends its bashed-up old flying machine. Its official name is Davis-Monthan Air Force Base, and it's in the Arizona desert. It's high and dry out here, and the ground is alkaline, not acidic, so stuff doesn't even rust. Some are in full working order.
I'm feeling just fine.
Some are kept for spare parts, and some, like this Lockheed C-141 Starlifter, just need to be ripped to pieces. Because after 40,000 hours of flying, the airframe has metal fatigue. You couldn't pay me enough money to fly in this hunk of junk.
I told you I feel fine.
This Vietnam era veteran first flew in the 60s. In the 70s, they brought back POWs when the Vietnam War ended. And in the 90s, they ferried men and equipment to the Middle East for Operation Desert Storm. Now, there's a man in it who doesn't seem to know where he is. I hope he's not waiting for it to take off.
Would the confused gentleman in the empty plane please report to security? This plane stopped service 10 years ago. Thank you.
If you thought they had some fancy way of breaking up old planes, oh look, there he is again! Well, they don't. These pods used to carry four 21,000-pound thrust jet engines. Not anymore. It's frickin' eating the plane! Seriously, that big digger claw thing is eating the plane! 3,200 square feet of wings. And the tail was over 39 feet tall. That's like stacking six Michael Jordans. Not that you would ever want to do that. He was a monster. This fuselage once carried hundreds of troops, vehicles, supplies, maybe even intercontinental ballistic missiles. Now it's having its guts eaten by a machine controlled by that confused man driving a big claw.
It's so humiliating.
In minutes, it's a filthy carnage of aluminum, steel, and titanium. It cost $8 million to build in the 60s. Now it's worth about 20,000 smackers of scrap. And the journey is just beginning. This humiliation is about to go extreme. Once the corpse has been broken up, it's carried out to a nearby breaker's yard. Here they have to separate out the different metals. Is that Bender from Futurama? Hey! The Starlifter's almost unrecognizable by now. Bits of the airframe are fed into a mill where they're shredded by terrifying steel spikes. Out come thousands of pieces. There are all kinds of materials here. Old dentures, boxer shorts lost down the back of the seat, and a small piece of pie. But only the metal is worth anything. At the end of the conveyor, a powerful magnet literally sucks the steel into a separate hopper, allowing the less magnetic aluminum and titanium to drop onto another conveyor. A manual check removes any other materials, like that one and that one, and a 148,000-pound jet has been reduced to this pathetic jumble of scrap. It's the end of the line for the Starlifter. But of course, not for the metal. It'll be melted down, turned into ingots, and who knows where it'll end up after that. Perhaps it'll be cutlery, a sword, a superhero suit, or a Harley Davidson.